Welcome back, everyone. Building a green economy, creating more jobs in the process, and more strict emission standards. It all sounds pretty good, but not everyone is behind the clean energy bill making its way through the Wisconsin legislature right now. Tom Still, president of the Wisconsin Technology Council, is here this afternoon with some insight. You're fresh off of a meeting this afternoon where this was the topic.
Oh, yeah. It was a part of a conversation around some of the energy resources and strategies through the UW-Madison, in particular the College of Engineering, and how there's a lot of things going on between the academic world and the business world to really push the envelope on sustainable energy. But as you noted at the outset, there are some issues probably that have emerged around the Clean Energy Act and how some people perceive that.
What is it about the act? You wrote a blog that came out this morning that really laid out a case against pushing the emission standards too far.
Oh, I think where some, especially in the business community in Wisconsin, have raised some concerns have been that they worry about Wisconsin getting so far ahead of the curve that there are competitiveness issues. In other words, are we so far ahead of Iowa, Michigan, and Illinois, and our neighbors, and whoever else, that it really is a disadvantage for business here? Now, the flip side of that is, obviously, Wisconsin wants to be at the cusp of this kind of innovation because it's ultimately where we're all going to need to be.
For people that don't understand where there could be a downside to this, though, Tom, can you talk about that?
Sure. Let's just use, for example, vehicle emission standards. The act as it is right now in the legislature would tie Wisconsin standards to those in California, which are actually above and beyond what the Environmental Protection Agency right now will enforce. And in fact, there's a lot of questions about that. So while those may be very vigorous standards, it could set Wisconsin apart and could mean that some things would happen in Wisconsin that perhaps would cost jobs, might cost income, might present some lost opportunities, at least in the short term and the midterm.
Okay, so there are a lot of issues that are covered in this bill. Shifts to renewable resources, emission standards, creating green jobs. If you're going to break it down for the average consumer out there to really know what to watch for, know what to look for, the concerns reached both sides of the aisle on this issue, by the way, on this particular legislation. Talk about what you think is key for people to keep an eye on.
Well, I think a couple of the major areas, and this is where greenhouse gases are most commonly emitted, transportation side, that means vehicles, our cars, our trucks, other vehicles, and then on electricity generation side. And there the bill sets some aggressive standards about renewable energy generation. In other words, how big is that renewable portfolio over time? It rises to 25% by 2025. Pretty aggressive. Then the question becomes, how do you reach that really with some of the technologies that are there today? And nuclear generation then becomes a part of that portfolio because it is, among all things else, it's greenhouse free.
All right, we're out of time, but there's so much more to cover here, so Tom, we'll have you back on soon and
absolutely
keep exploring the issues that we'll be facing here
as
this legislation makes its way through.